Hello friends, how are you? I hope you all are good. Now today's I know your today's whatever exam of on our P block elements, okay, chemistry, it was also good, okay, you score maximum in that. So see here, whatever P block elements, before starting our discussion of major test, you must know what is a P block elements, and you prior only studied in 11th standard group 13 and 14 you studied in that, at any cost you must know what is the basics behind these P block elements, okay. So basics means what, as you know beta, in that some important trends, periodic trends, for example atomic size, ionic size, okay, ionic enthalpy, electronegativity, electron affinity. So these are what, some important periodic trends, okay. At any cost you must know what will happen along the period down to the group, okay. You must know each and every correctly. In chemistry, perfection is important, okay. You keep in mind this word, perfection is important in our chemistry, okay. So see here, we will start now our discussion, okay, major test discussion. So for that, okay, for that, see here, whatever our question number 26, so what they give in question number 26, okay, so we will see that in question number 26, which one of the following combines with iron second ions to form a bound brown complex, to form what? Brown complex, okay. So see here, brown complex, question number 26, JEE, okay. So as you know this beta, whatever this, when your say, when your iron second is combined with nitric oxide, when it combines with nitric oxide, nitric oxide, it gives what, a brown complex, or we can call it as a what beta, in one test, okay, brown ring test also there in our this P block element, okay. So that brown complex, so here option is what beta, nitric oxide is what, simply no, NO, small b here option, understood. So now see here, question number 27, okay. So see here in question number 27, what they ask, which of the following is a tetrabasic acid. So see here, they gave option orthophosphorus, then orthophosphoric, metaphosphoric and pyrophosphoric. So here your correct option is what, small d, that's small d is what beta, pyrophosphoric acid, what beta, pyrophosphoric, yes, pyrophosphoric acid having formula is what, yes, H4P2O7. So H4P2O7, how was the structure, act like this here, P double bond O, here what beta OH, here also OH, okay, so like that, here linkage, understood. Here see H4P2O7, here 3 and here 3 and this 7, understood. So these are what, question number 26 and question number 27, okay. So now we will discuss here next question number 28, so be ready for question number, yes beta, question number 28. So see here in question number 28, okay, so in question number 28, phosphine is prepared by the reaction of, so as you know, very much important is content regarding phosphine, okay. So when it will form here phosphine, P4 plus NaOH, okay beta, yes, P4 plus NaOH plus H2, then and then only you will get what, phosphine, along with sodium hypophosphite, Na2H, okay, NaH2PO2, NaH2PO2, this what beta, phosphine is what, PH3, And these are what? NaH2PO2, sodium hypophosphite. What beta? Sodium hypophosphite. So here, what will be here option? Yes, 28B. Now see here in question number 29. So beta, in question number 29, which of the following is not known? You can easily identify among these all four options, which one is what not known. Yes, here what beta option? A, NCl5 is not known. Why? Because here absence of d orbital. D orbitals or absence of d subshell in nitrogen. Okay, understood this. Now we will move towards question number 30. So in question number 30, ammonium nitrate decomposes on heating into ammonium nitrate. You must know here formula. Ammonium nitrate is what beta? Yes, ammonium nitrate is what? NH4NO3. When you heat this, okay, when your ammonium nitrate heat, so it gives what? Yes, nitrous oxide, N2O. What beta is? Nitrous oxide, N2O. It is also called as what? Laughing gas. Yes, laughing gas plus H2O. So here you can balance your reaction. Okay, understood. So these are what beta? Question number 28, 29 and 30. Okay, I hope you understood this all. So what is the option of question number 30? Yes beta, B option. What beta here option? Your B, nitrous oxide and water. Okay, now see here, we will discuss question number 31. Ready? So see, basicity. What basicity of orthophosphoric acid? So orthophosphoric acid basically what? Yes, your orthophosphoric acid is what? H3PO4. Understood? As you know this, orthophosphoric acid, we can call it as orthophosphoric acid. Then phosphoric acid also simply. So see here what? H3PO4. Phosphoric acid, or we can say what? Orthophosphoric acid. Understood? So you must know how to draw the structure of this as like this. See, HOOH, and here also was OH. So tribasic acid. So basically how much? 3. So beta, 31 option is what? Basically 3. 31 option is what? B. Understood? So see, 32, HNO2 act as a, yes, your HNO2 act as a what? Both A and B. So both, when you are saying both A and B means what? Both oxidizing as well as reducing agent. Oxidizing agent as well as, yes, as well as reducing agent. Understood this thing? Okay, so why it is so like this? So here option, as you know what, C option, it will, you are correct. So because if you will observe here, so whenever you are taking example of this ferrous ion, so whatever this HNO2, it has a tendency towards oxidize. This means here it what? Understood? Fe2+ convert into Fe3+, means oxidation will occur. Okay, understood. And if you are considering here another example for this, okay, so see here, your KMnO4 is reduced, means among the KMnO4 beta, MnO4 minus, that is what, convert into Mn+2 with the help of this what? HNO2. Understood? Means here what? Oxidation. Here what beta? Reduction. Means +7 to +2, and here what? +2 to +3, means increase in oxidation number, and here what? Decrease in oxidation number. Okay, therefore whatever your HNO2, it act as a both oxidizing as well as reducing agent. Okay, so these are what beta? Question number 31 and 32. Okay, so now see here, we will discuss here, yes, question number 33. Ready? So see what they give. nitrogen dioxide cannot be obtained by heating.
Yes, A option, your KNO3 beta. When your KNO3 is heated, it gives what always? KNO2 solid plus O2. Okay, so here no any removal of your nitrogen dioxide. So your option is what? A.
Okay, so see here, question number 34. Which of the following elements listed below occur in allotropic form? Yes, your what?
C. Sulfur only forms allotropes. Which are there? Monoclinic. What beta? Suppose if you are considering your allotropic forms, yes, monoclinic, then what? Rhombic sulfur. Okay, rhombic sulfur, then what? Yes, we can write here plastic sulfur also. Understood. So your option, you got what beta here? Option C, 34. Say now, see beta here, 35. Bond angle is minimum for what beta? So say bond angle is minimum for what? D, H2T. Okay, hydrogen sulfur, hydrogen telluride. What beta? Hydrogen telluride. So why it is so? Because as you know beta, down to the group electronegativity decreases, and due to which repulsion between the bond pair, okay, bond pairs of electron also decreases, hence bond angle also decreases. Okay, so it is the reason behind this option. Now question number 36. So beta, question number 36, oxygen molecule exhibits, because whatever this question number 36, very much interesting this question. So many times in theory also they ask question, okay, oxygen in which form, diamagnetic or paramagnetic, how and why. So here oxygen molecule exhibits A only option, what? Paramagnetism. What beta? Paramagnetic character they are showing. Okay, why? Because as you know, in 11th standard our topic chemical bonding and molecular structure, in that advanced theory, that is molecular orbital theory, you draw such a diagram. Okay, sigma 1s, sigma star, sigma 1s, sigma 2s. Okay, pi to px, pi star to px. Okay, pi to py, pi star to py. Okay, as such type of diagram you drawn in 11th standard. So here what is the reason? Okay, why it is? Because two unpaired electrons are present in antibonding molecular orbitals. Whatever two unpaired electrons are present in antibonding molecular orbitals, we can call it as a what? ABMOs. What? ABMOs, antibonding molecular orbitals. It where that pi star to px and what? Pi star to py. In these orbitals there is a what? 1-1 unpaired electron. That's why your O2 is what? Paramagnetic. Okay, so now we will discuss beta question number next, that is question number 37. Be ready for question number 37. Okay, so see here, what is the question number 37? When oxygen pass through solution of any NO2SO3, sodium what? Sulfite. Okay, when oxygen is passed. Okay, so what is your option? So see here beta, when this Na2SO3 is passed O2, so it will convert into what beta? Yes, here you will get what? Sodium sulfate, means sulfide convert into sulfate. So oxidation it will occur.
So what beta? Your option is what here? Small a. Next question number 38. When H2S passed through acidified KMnO4 in a poor solution. Okay. Acidified KMnO4 in a poor solution. We get what? Acidified. See here beta. Acidified means what? Okay. So same such type of numerical or such type of examples. It is in your NCERT content, okay, in molecular equation forms. Okay, so you have to write like this, question number 38. So see here, you have to complete this reaction. Your KMnO4 plus, yes, H2SO4 beta, plus what? Yes, plus H2S. Then it gives what? It is converted into your K2SO4. This molecular equation they gave in your NCERT also, plus MnOSO4 plus H2O plus 5-sulfur. Okay, so here we want to balance the reaction. So here 8, then here how much beta? Here 2. So you have to balance like this 2, then how many H2SO4? Yes, 3. Okay, same reaction beta we can balance in ionic form also. Okay, so that ionic form of reaction in terms of KMnO4, it is in DNA block elements. Okay, understood this? Very much easy. And so here beta option is what? Yes, your D option, sulfur. Yes, D option is your sulfur here, question number 38. Now we will see question number 39. Okay, a solution of sulfur dioxide in water reacts with H2S, precipitating sulfur. Here sulfur dioxide is act as a, okay, so see here, what is the role of here sulfur dioxide? So see, as like this reaction, H2S plus SO2, so what you here, H2O plus, you will get here sulfur only. So balance this reaction as like this. Okay, so see here, yes, our reaction is balanced. 4 hydrogen 4 hydrogen, yes, 3s oxygen also 2. Okay, so these are what beta? These are your H2S is here reducing agent and is what beta? Oxidizing agent. So here in this reaction, what in this reaction your SO2 is what? Oxidizing agent, because here reduction will occur for this SO2. How? See here, how it will here reaction reduction will occur, that's why it is oxidizing agent. Itself reduces, therefore it is what? Oxidizing agent. So how? See here, suppose if you are considering SO2, X plus oxygen what? Minus 4. So how much here? Plus 4. And here what? Sulfur 0, means plus 4 to 0. What will occur? Reduction. Understood. Okay, so therefore you are this SO2 here what? Oxidizing agent. Okay, so now I will discuss here question number 40. Ready for question number 40? Now see here, question number 40. When SO2 is passed through acidified K2Cr2O7 solution. Okay, so here also we need what? Molecular equation. Okay, as like this, it is also present in your DNA block and P block also. So CCR K2Cr2O7 plus what? H2SO4 in acidic medium we want, plus what? Here SO2. So what will happen here? Yes, you will get what here? K2SO4 plus, yes, plus what you will get? Cr2SO4 thrice plus H2O. Okay, so this Cr2SO4 thrice is what? Green in color. Okay, so you have to balance this reaction, then you will get what? Easy, you will get answer here. Okay, so now we will discuss here question number 41. Okay, so for question number 41 beta, which of the following is acidic? You must know which of the following acidic. Okay, so see here, option they gave SO3, then N2O, BuO, MgO. So when it will react with water, so SO3 plus H2O. So what it will get? Yes, H2SO4 acid. So your option is what, beta? A. And 40 is what? D. Okay. Now see question number 42. So see here, 42. Oxalic acid when heated with H2SO4 gives out. So see here. This what? Here you must know, beta, oxalic acid formula. Oxalic acid dot twice H2O complete formula. Okay. So when it what? It is heated with the concentrated H2SO4. So it gives what, beta? Yes. H2O plus CO plus CO2. Okay. So see here, reaction also balance 2 hydrogen, yes, 2 hydrogen, 2 and 2 4 oxygen, yes, 2 carbon atom. Okay, so products are what? CO and plus CO2. Okay. Now see here, question number. Yes. We will discuss here question number 43. Okay. So we will discuss here question number 43. So ready? Question number 43. Which one of the gas dissolved in H2SO4 gives oleum? Yes, gives oleum. Your H2SO4. Okay. So beta, what? H2SO4 plus SO3. It gives what? Oleum. Yes. What it is? H2SO7. It is what your oleum, or we can say fuming sulfuric acid. What, beta? Fuming sulfuric acid. Now 44. Yes, question number 44 is what? Phosgene is the common name of what? Carbonyl chloride. We already studied in haloalkanes and halorine topic from organic. Okay, in that polyhalogen compounds, we discussed this. Phosgene, that is carbonyl chloride, as like this COCl2. Okay. Next, question number 45. Like that, you must do comparatively study. Okay. Some points and some content, it was repeated in some other topics. So at that time, you have to identify when we studied this. So you have to what? It becomes easy for your better understanding. Okay. So like that, you do comparatively study, you do, it will always what? Beneficial for you. Understood? So here, question number 45. The strongest acid among the following is strongest acid. So as you know, beta, HClO4 among these acid is strongest. Why? Because if you discuss here, oxidation number increases, acidic character and what? Yes, acidic character also increases. So see here, see this chlorine atom, you have to identify oxidation number. So plus 1 plus x plus what, beta? Minus 8. So how much? Yes, plus 7. Another, if you you have to calculate, you have to write HClO3, HClO2 and HClO. And see this much, this what? Your HClO4 is highest oxidation number, so that's why it is what? Highly acidic. Understood, beta? Like that, simple. Okay. Now it will what? Numeral type questions, integer type questions. Okay. Question number 46, numeral type question. You have to type only numeral, or you have to enter into numeral. The oxidation number of xenon in XCOF2. Okay, so how much, beta? Here, see here, xenon we want, so X we consider, minus 2 plus 2 into minus 1 is equal to 0. So X, beta, how much it will come? Obviously 4. So you have to enter into 4. You have to write only 4 there. Okay, question of 47. Total number of lone pairs of electrons in XCOF4. So you must know here structure as like this XCOF4. Okay, so like this structure, how much lone pairs? So see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so one only lone pair. So answer is what? 1.
Understood. Now question number 48.
Okay. So see here,
beta, question number 48. Dissociation of H3PO4 occurs in how many steps? Dissociation of H3PO4. So see here, we will start H3PO4 dissociation. So what first, beta? Yes, H plus plus. H2PO4 minus, yes or no? Then again this you have to take H2PO4 minus, what you will get? H plus plus HPO4 2 minus. Then again you have to take this HPO4 2 minus, that is what? H plus plus PO4 3 minus. So total how many ways? 3. So your answer is what? 3. Okay, understood this thing? Like that, simple what questions? Now see, question number 49. Nitrogen forms how many oxides? Yes, total 5 oxides. Which are those? See here. First is what? Your NO, nitric oxide. Then second is what? N2O. Yes. Third is what? N2O3. Yes or no? N2O3, then fourth, yes beta, N2O4, okay, then fifth is what? N2O5, these are what? Oxides, understood? Okay, so these are what? Question number 48 and 49. Last but not least question, okay, that is question number 50. The number of hydroxyl groups in the pyrophosphoric acid. So you must know here, what is the pyrophosphoric acid? We already studied and that question also over. H4P2O7. So here you have to draw, how to draw the structure, you must know. Okay. So as like this, understood. So H4P2O7, so much. How many hydroxyl group? 4. So you have to enter into 4 only. Okay. I hope you understood all this. Okay. If any doubt will come, you can send on WhatsApp. So stay safe and take care. Thank you very much.